ಮಾಲ್ಡೀವ್ಸ್ ಬಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಯಡಿಯೂರಪ್ಪ ಏನು ಕೊಟ್ಟರೆ ಗಿಫ್ಟು ಪಿಎಂಗೆ
सर अड्डा बन
सर अड्डा बन पड़े सर इंडिया बनने हो गए
ना अड्डा पर बिड़े ना अड्डा पर बिड़े बंदा का
दिल्ली अशोक दलवाई नम रैतर आदाय द्विगुणगुण योजन मुख्यस्थर और बंद सुमार एर तासू रिपोर्ट को अदर विवर को यी मुंबल विवर को कर्नाटक रैतर आदाय द्विगुण के भालाष्टु आसक्ति तक नमु मोदे राज्य आगे नम बैके द्विगुण आगोदे एर सवि इपत्मू इपत्नाक द्विगुण आगे अद्कि हलवु क्रम तक आवश्यकता है वनू केंद्र सरकार नम जो कई जोड़ू सिद्धर रैतर आदाय द्विगुण दृष्टिया अदे नम कृषिक ರೈತರಿರುವಂತ ಒಂದು ಸಮಿತಿಯನ್ನ ನಾವು ನೇಮಿಸುತ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇವೆ ಅವರು ಕೇಂದ್ರ ಸರ್ಕಾರ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ನಿರಂತರವಾಗಿ ಸಂಪರ್ಕ ಇಟ್ಟು ನಮ್ಮದೇ ಆದಂತ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಸ್ಪೆಸಿಫಿಕ್ ನಮ್ಮದೇ ಆದಂತ ಕೃಷಿಕರ ಆದಾಯ ರಿಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಅನ್ನು ಸಿದ್ಧಪಡಿಸಿ ಅದನ್ನ ನಾವು ಇಂಪ್ಲಿಮೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡೋ ಸಲುವಾಗಿ ಒಂದು ಎರಡನೇದಾಗಿ ಅಗ್ರಿಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಿಟಿಗಳನ್ನು ಬಳಕೆ ಮಾಡಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಸೀಡ್ ಮ್ಯಾನೇಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಪೆಸ್ಟ್ ಮ್ಯಾನೇಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಫರ್ಟಿಲೈಸರ್ ಮ್ಯಾನೇಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಹೆಂಗೆ ನಾವು ಇಂಪ್ರೂವ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ನಮ್ಮ ಭೂಮಿ ಸತ್ವ ಹೆಂಗ್ ಇಂಪ್ರೂವ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಎಲ್ಲ ಸಲುವಾಗಿ ಅಗ್ರಿಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಿಟಿ ಸಹಾಯವನ್ನ ತೆಗೆದುಕೊಂಡು ಮಾಡೋ ಸಲುವಾಗಿ ಅಗ್ರಿಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಡಿಪಾರ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ನಲ್ಲಿ ಅಗ್ರಿಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್ ನೇತೃತ್ವದಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಸಮಿತಿಯನ್ನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇವೆ ಮೂರನೇದು ಹಾರ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಸೆರಿಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಅಗ್ರಿಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಮತ್ತು ಅನಿಮಲ್ ಹಸ್ಬೆಂಡ್ರಿ ಡೇರಿ ಫಿಶರಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಅಗ್ರೋ ಪ್ರಾಡಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ प्रोसेसिंग यूनिट अरे ना कृषिया उत्पन्न अदर मौल्य वृद्धि सल फुड प्रोसेसिंग सल विशेषवान टास्क फोर्स ನಾವು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇವೆ. ಒಂದು ಸೆಕೆಂಡರಿ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಹೆಸರಿನಿಟ್ಟಿದ್ದೇವೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಸೆಕ್ರೆಟರೇಟ್ ಅನ್ನು ಮಾಡಬೇಕನ್ನುವಂಥ ತೀರ್ಮಾನವನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೇವೆ. ಇದು ಅಗ್ರಿಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಸಲುವಾಗಿ ಭಾಳ ದೊಡ್ಡ ಬದಲಾವಣೆ ಮಾಡುವಂಥ ಒಂದು ತೀರ್ಮಾನಗಳು ನಾವು ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೇವೆ. ಇವುಗಳನ್ನು ಬರುವಂಥ ದಿನಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಇದರ ಆಧಾರದ ಮೇಲೆ ನಮ್ಮ ರೈತರ ಆದಾಯ ದ್ವಿಗುಣ ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕ್ರಮ ಇದು ಭಾಳ ವರ್ಷದ ನಂತರ ಬಿ ಜೆ ಪಿಯ ಒಬ್ಬರು ಮೇಯರು ಆಗಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ನಾನು ಅಲ್ಲಿಯ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕಾರ್ಪೊರೇಟರ್ಸ್ಗೆ ಮತ್ತು ಅಲ್ಲಿಯ ಜನತೆಗೆ ಧನ್ಯವಾದಗಳನ್ನು ಹೇಳ್ತೇನೆ. ಅದೇ ರೀತಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಇನ್ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಮಂತ್ರಿಗಳಂಥ ಸೋಮಶೇಖರ್ ಅವರು, ಅಶೋಕ್ ಅವರು, ನಮ್ಮ ಶಾಸಕರು ನಾಗೇಂದ್ರ ಅವರು, ರಾಮದಾಸ್ ಅವರು ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಮತ್ತು ನಮ್ಮ ಕಾರ್ಯಕರ್ತರು, ನಮ್ಮ ಅಧ್ಯಕ್ಷರು ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಸೇರಿ ಇದನ್ನು ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅವ್ರಿಗೆಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಕೂಡ ಅಭಿನಂದನೆಗಳನ್ನು
ಸಲ್ಲಿಸ್ತೇನೆ.
ದಿಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇನೆ, ದಿಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇನೆ. ಈಗ 1:20 ಫ್ಲೈಟಲ್ಲಿ ಹೋಗ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇನೆ. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇವತ್ತು ಅಗ್ರಿಕಲ್ಚರ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟ್ರು ಮತ್ತು ಜಲಶಕ್ತಿ ಮಂತ್ರಿಗಳನ್ನು ಭೇಟಿಯಾಗ್ತಿದ್ದೀನಿ. ನಾಳೆ ಹಣಕಾಸಿನ ಸಚಿವರು ಮತ್ತು ನಮ್ಮ ಗಡ್ಕರಿ ಅವ್ರನ್ನ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕೂಡ ಭೇಟಿಯಾಗ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ. ಸಾಯಂಕಾಲ ನಡ್ಡಾಜಿ ಅವರ ಸಮಯ ಕೇಳಿದ್ದೇನೆ, ಅವ್ರು ಕೊಟ್ಟ ತಕ್ಷಣ ಅವ್ರನ್ನು ಭೇಟಿಯಾಗ್ತಾರೆ. ಧನ್ಯವಾದ.
ಇವತ್ತು ವೊಲ್ವೋ ಕಾರ್ಪೊರೇಷನ್ ಅವರೊಟ್ಟಿಗೆ ನಾರಾಯಣ ಹೃದಯಾಲಯ ಒಟ್ಟು ಸೇರಿ ಈ ವ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿನೇಷನ್ ಬಸ್ ಅಂತ ನಾವು ಲಾಂಚ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೇವೆ. ನಮ್ಮ ಉದ್ದೇಶ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ವ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿನೇಷನ್ ಇದೆಯಲ್ಲ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ವ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿನೇಷನ್ ಅಗೇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕೋವಿಡ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ವ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿನೇಷನ್ ಅಗೇನ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಡೆತ್. ಸೊ ನಮ್ಮ ಉದ್ದೇಶ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ನಮ್ಮ ಭಾರತೀಯ ಜನರು ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ವ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿನೇಷನ್ ತಗೊಳ್ಬೇಕು. ರಿಮೋಟ್ ಲೊಕೇಶನ್ಲ್ಲಿ ಇದ್ದವರಿಗೆ ಬ್ಯಾಂಗ್ಳೂರಿಗೆ ಬಂದು ವ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿನೇಷನ್ ತಗೊಳ್ಳಿಕ್ಕೆ ಕಷ್ಟ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಅಂಥವರಿಗೆ ನಾವು ಫೆಸಿಲಿಟಿ ಅರೇಂಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೇವೆ. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಸೋ ಮಚ್. ಲಾಂಚ್ ದಿಸ್
Having said that, we should allow the children to get vaccinated. That's the first thing. And all the schools should take all the precautions. Anyone, any adult working in school should be vaccinated. Otherwise, they should be working. And at regular intervals, all the children and these teachers, COVID status should be checked. If you do that, it is safe. We cannot keep the school closed forever. It has to open. And it has to be done exactly like what the Karnataka government has done, in a very, very phased manner, very, very cautious.
One last thing, you know, considering that incentives have been given to the people.
In a true democratic country, every citizen has the right to choose. But as a citizen, I have taken my vaccine. And I believe that those who are vaccinated naturally have the right to demand that why should I take if other people are enjoying the same benefit as what I have. A lot of countries have started imposing restrictions on restaurants and the public transport kept away from people who are not vaccinated. I don't think we are ready yet because we don't have that degree of supply of vaccine. If they turn around and ask, you know, give me the vaccine, I'm going to vaccinate. If everyone wants it, we may not have vaccine. Let's do it at the right time.
Sir.
And in line with that initiative, what we have done is, we have said that let vaccination reach to people who cannot reach places, especially the elderly, responsibility. So we are launching this campaign in collaboration with Narayan Hridayalaya and CII to reach out to various urban areas, semi-urban areas and rural Karnataka, so we can reach to many people. We can provide vaccinations through a bus which has been specially repurposed for that purpose. We have 4 vaccination stations inside. We have a proper registration system on the application, on the app with Wi-Fi and router. We have refrigeration system for the cold chain so that these vaccines can be kept at the right temperature, because that's something very, very important. We have not cut corners on that. And even if there is no power, if there is a power failure, this will remain at the same temperature for 72 hours for almost.
But only one bus. Why not more buses?
We have started this because we can vaccinate almost 1,000 people per day, 800 to 1,000 people per day. Let us start with this initiative because this is an important one. Based on the success of this, if there is more demand, I think CII, the industry, is willing to join hands to extend the helping hand to the country.
So this is only in Karnataka?
This will be started with Karnataka focus, and depends on what we need further. We will see as it evolves.
Do you have a timetable?
Sir, one second.
Yeah, all that is set. We are going to visit more than 6 or 7 districts of Karnataka, and this will be a campaign over 4 to 6 months. Next 4 to 6 months, we intend to cover, if everything goes well, almost 1 lakh doses of vaccines to people.
Devi Shetty sir, the wave committee sir, the own representatives of the government are seeking public gatherings. Would you recommend to the government to be very strict about this gatherings, sir, because now festivals are happening?
Right now we are talking about the vaccination. CII president is here. Would you like to say something?
Sure. So, what I would like, I represent the CII as chairman for the Karnataka State Council. So, we've been working very closely with Volvo and Narayan Hirudale, and we really appreciate the initiative they have taken to set this in motion. You know, wheels in motion, pun unintended, but they've really got this one in motion. And all the member companies of CII in Karnataka are well behind this initiative, and we will look to amplify the efforts of Volvo and Narayan Hirudale through the participation of our members as well across the state.
But more buses, such buses are required as for the rural India.
Correct. As Mr. Bali already mentioned, that we will learn from this one, the first bus, see the success and see the uptake from this bus. And then there is strong commitment from CII and the member companies to expand this.
Sir, how much does it cost, sir?
Yes. The priority would be also already been set by between
been
Volvo.
Been set, a roadmap has been made.
The roadmap has been made, and we will follow that.
Thank you, sir. Please explain.
See, when COVID-19 started 1.5 years ago, no doctor in the world had an idea. No doctor in the world had an idea how to deal with this disease. We had no idea whether we are going to be alive in treating COVID patients, because nobody had an idea. We thought it's a very deadly disease. 1 year later, technology development happened in a manner that we have vaccines. Amazing. But everyone had a doubt whether vaccine is going to work. And there are a lot of social media campaigning that it may not work, it is dangerous. Today, we know that COVID vaccine is not the vaccine against COVID-19. It is a vaccine against death. You look at the number of people who are infected in US, look at the number of people who are infected in Israel, and look at the number of people who are in the ICU on the ventilator. It is very, very small. There is no doubt today that vaccination works. So my request to every citizen of India, please do not doubt the modern science. Science has proven without doubt that the COVID vaccination works. Please get yourself and your loved ones vaccinated.
Sir,
thank you.
Sir, where?
All the companies are now doubled or tripled their production. In the next few weeks, I'm confident there will be adequate number of vaccines available.
Sir, your take on endemic, sir?
We are only living in Bangalore. We think Bangalore had very high incidence of large number of people are vaccinated. But what about rural India? For them to lose 1 day of wages, come here to Bangalore, find a place where to find the vaccination center, it's very hard. So our idea is that we have all the technological support. We have company like Volvo supporting. We have doctors in our group, nurses in our group who are willing to do it. We will go to village and vaccinate. That's the whole thing.
Sir, you are a chairman of the third wave committee, sir. The government...
I don't think any of the politicians have asked the people to break the code of COVID-19 prevention. I don't think so. And even if somebody has felt it, they didn't mean it. We have to follow the COVID norms at least for another 2 years.
Okay,
thank you, sir. Video.
Joseph. thing is the PPP thing, you know. If you can just interact with each other, something. Yeah. Once again, you like that?
Okay, thank you.
ಸ್ಕೂಲ್ ಗವರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಹತ್ರ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದೇವೆ, ಫೇಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾನರ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್ ಓಪನ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಂತ ಎಲ್ಲ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪರ್ಟ್ ಒಪಿನಿಯನ್ ತಗೊಂಡು ಎಲ್ಲರೂ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಅದೇ ತರ ಗವರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅಂಡ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ರೈಟ್ ವೇ ಟು ಡೂ ಇಟ್. ಐ ಆಮ್ ಆಪ್ಟಿಮಿಸ್ಟಿಕ್ ಇದು ಸಕ್ಸಸ್ಫುಲ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಮತ್ತೆ ಪುನಃ ಸರ್ಕಾರದವರು ಆಲೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡಿ ಎಣಿಸ್ತಾರೆ ಈ ಸಣ್ಣ ಮಕ್ಕಳಿಗೆ ಯಾವಾಗ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡೋದು.
ಇವತ್ತಿನ ಸಿಚುವೇಶನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಗಣೇಶೋತ್ಸವವನ್ನು ಪಬ್ಲಿಕ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾಡಬಹುದಾ?
ನಾನು ಅದನ್ನು ಹೇಳಿಕ್ಕಾಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು.